fill up, fill out, and fill in. These are all phrasal verbs, and these are what we are going to talk about in this video. Can you be one of my respondents? And what you are going to do is to fill up this survey form. Oh, teka, my friend. Tama bang gamitin ang fill up in this case? Do you want to feed your curiosity and confusion? Stay tuned! If you are a fan of learning English, feel free to visit my channel for more videos. Let's start with fill out. Means to complete a form, survey, questionnaire, or document by adding the information that are being asked. So, ginagamit naman pala natin ang fill out kapag ang nais nating iparating o ipahiwatig ay paglalagay o pagpupuno ng impormasyon na hinihingi sa kaperasong papel. Ngayon, ka-dreamer, alam nyo na, mali palang gamitin ang fill up. No? Okay, let me give you examples to help you get along with. For instance, would you fill out this enrollment form? Fill out ang dapat gamitin kapag naglalagay o pagsasagot ng impormasyon sa kaperasong papel. Enrollment form, survey form, questionnaire, or document. Another instance, let us suppose that you are a researcher and you must have target respondents. And I am a researcher too, and I am proud that I already have target respondents who are going to fill out this survey form that I have prepared for them to be able to gather the information, thoughts, or ideas that need to strengthen my claims as a researcher. Fill up means to make something become completely full. Okay. For instance, would you fill up this cup with warm water? Would you fill up this cup with warm water? Sure, I will fill up that cup with warm water for you, my highness. Fill in means to inform or give some details for someone with regard to a particular thing that he or she has missed. Ang unang gamit naman pala ng fill in ay pagpapaalala o pagbibigay ng detalyadong impormasyon patungkol sa isang bagay na nakaligtaan o hindi napanood ng isang tao. For instance, I missed the 4th episode of Provinciano. Would you fill me in? What happened? Okay. Hindi ko napanood ang ika-4 na yugto ng Provinciano. Maari mo bang sabihin sa akin kung ano ang nangyari? It is as simple as that. Ang last na gamit naman nito ay to substitute for someone who is an absent. O sa Filipino naman ay pagpalit sa isang tao na hindi makakapasok sa trabaho. Parang ganun. Halimbawa, Rose may not be able to work tomorrow. Could you fill in for her? Rose may not be able to work tomorrow. Could you fill in for her? Si Rose ay hindi makakapasok bukas. Maaari ka bang pumalit sa kanya? Yes! I have already explained to you the differences of these 3 phrasal verbs. Let me sum it up to you. Okay. Fill out means to complete a form, survey, questionnaire, or document. Fill up means to make something become completely full. Meanwhile, fill in is to substitute for someone who is an absent. And the last usage of fill in is that to inform or give some details for someone with regard to a particular thing that he or she is missed. Okay, now it's already vivid to you. It's my turn to give you a quiz. in order for me to measure or determine if you have had something from me. Okay, it's your turn to take that quiz. That would be all for today's video, mga creamers. If you're watching this video on my FB page, follow my FB page for more videos. But if you are watching this video on my YouTube channel, make sure you subscribe and click that bell icon so that you will get notified every time a new video is added. That will help you stay motivated to study English. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video, mga creamers. Happy learning!